So I basically wanted to make a quick video on this edit. So many people DM'd me on Instagram asking me how I edited my photo. So if you have been following me on Instagram, then you might have seen me upload these kind of photos with this look. So I suggest you to follow me on Instagram so you can see more such edits and you can ask me how I edited them, and I might just end up making a video like this again. Anyway, so my basic point is that many people like this look, so I thought of making a tutorial on it. So this is basically a Snapchat lens. Like sometimes I use the Snapchat lens when I just shoot it directly so that I don't have to go the process of editing and other stuff. Else you can just use Lightroom to recreate this. So we'll be basically recreating it using Lightroom. So I'll tell you the name of the Snapchat lens. I kind of forgot the name. So the Snapchat lens is called Urban by Saman Hassan. So if you're on Snapchat, then you can check out the Snapchat lens and you can just directly click photos using that. However, if you want to edit some pre-clicked or previously clicked photos, then you can watch this video till the end and you'll get to know how you can edit your photos in that way. If you are new over here, then I am Prithviraj and you're watching PR75K. So if this video helps, then please hit the subscribe button because it does help me a lot, and you'll also get to see more such videos like this that you might find helpful. So yeah, let's get started. And yeah, you better hit the subscribe button, else you know what I'll do.
Just do it, bruh.
Anyways, enough of those crappy talks. So this is what we are after. So this is the look we want to get. So I shot using the Snapchat lens, so I have a clean version of it as well, so we can just compare the two and edit them. So as you can see, this photo is quite dark, matte and desaturated. So if you like this kind of look, then you can check my Lightroom preset pack from the link given in the description. So it consists of 10 presets which you can download and use it for yourself. If you like this kind of edits, then I'm pretty sure you'll like that preset pack as well. So I recommend you to check that out because that's a one click process. Anyways, so let's continue with the tutorial. So this part, light, is quite self-explanatory, plus it also varies from photograph to photograph. So we'll be coming to this at the end, but for now we'll just decrease the saturation a bit. For example, minus 13 or minus 14 ish should be fine. And let's just move to the main part, which is the tone curve. So in the tone curve, we are looking for that S curve. So you can have to just make 3 points on the 3 segments, the whites, mids and the black. So we can just crush the whites a bit. And in the black section, you can just lift up the dark portion. Sorry about that. You can just lift it up like this. And as you can see in the shadows, it's giving the crushed gray kind of look which we are after. So this much should be fine for the tone curve as of now. Let's just adjust a little bit. Yeah, and this is the most easiest part in the HSL slider. So before that, as you can see, my hand is a bit yellowish over here and a bit orangish over here. So we'll just do that by dragging the yellows to orange. And that's pretty much done. And as you can see, everything else other than reds and yellows are desaturated. So all the colors, let's go to the saturation section and decrease the saturation of greens, aquas, blues, purples and magenta. So as you can see, we already have received that effect, but we can still do a lot better and we'll do it. So in the luminance section, just you can decrease the aqua as well. So that will kind of give that more grayish kind of look. The aquas will basically affect the two colors, which are the blues and the greens. So as you can see, my bands in both my hands kind of look similar now. And now what I like to do is to add a vignette, because I don't know why, it just gives a subtle touch to the photo and it looks really awesome according to me. And let's just go back to the light section now. It's too bright, so we can just decrease the highlights a bit. Increase the blacks, decrease the shadows and decrease the white as well. We are just basically decreasing everything to match the color. And the reds in the photo is kinda pinkish, so we can do that as well. Let's go to the HSL slider once again and we can just adjust the reds a bit, and then you can just reduce the saturation of it because we don't want that to be that kind of bright. One thing is that this photograph has a bluish kind of tint, but I'm not basically a fan of it. But if you want that bluish tint, then you can just go to that thing, split toning, and you can just change the highlights to blue and just increase the saturation a bit. Yeah, I think that much should be fine, and that kind of looks similar, maybe a little less. I just increased it a bit. Yeah, it's pretty close. We just have to do trial and error. So yeah, I'm quite happy with the look, to be honest. So I'll just keep it over here instead of aiming for the perfect blue on these two photos. So I'll just add it a bit from over here. The sharpness of this photo is huge, so you can get that HDR effect from increasing the sharpness. So as you can see, when I full zoom in, then it looks quite weird and HDR thing. I don't recommend that. You can just increase it to a subtle amount so that it looks better. So that's pretty much it. This is the basic edit. So I'll show you some other things. Like this thing doesn't really look good with photo product photos like this. You can just copy this preset. It looks great on portraits as well, so I'll just show it to you. You can just copy the preset by clicking on this button, and you can just hit the three dots on the top if you're using the Lightroom mobile and copy the preset, and you can paste it on any of your previous photographs. So let's just try with this model's photograph, which I found from some stock website. So you can just hit the paste button and it will basically paste the preset. So after that, you can just tweak the things you want to, like I want to decrease the highlights a lot, like this much should be fine, and the shadows as well a bit. So since this is a Snapchat filter, so it basically glorifies your skin tone a lot, so it looks great, and you can use it on your portraits as well. And that desaturated background, I just love it so much. I don't know why. I like the color blue, but not in photos. So yeah, that looks cool. So that's pretty much it, guys. So I basically wanted to make a quick editing tutorial. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, then you can hit the like button and hit subscribe button to support me. Else you can directly support me by checking out my preset pack from the link in the description. I'm pretty sure you'll like those presets if you liked this effect. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Till then, hasta la vista.